My name is Amit Etkin. We're at Stanford University, and I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Psychiatry and Behavioral Sciences. So I grew up in Israel. My hometown is actually kind of like Palo Alto. It's an academic town. There are several universities in that town. One of the big biomedical research institutes is in that town as well. My parents were both academics. My father was a computer scientist, and my mother did statistics. So my grandparents were actually also both scientists. We lived in the same house. We were on the bottom floor and they were on the top floor. They had emigrated to Israel in the 1930s from Poland and came to Israel as Zionists and as scientists to try to help found the country. I came to this country as an immigrant as well, and so there's a process of trying to fit in and understanding what your role is, what your possible contributions are. What we do is a lot of different things that all go towards answering a few big questions. Big questions is really, how does the human brain work at the level of brain circuits for things like how we regulate our emotions, how we regulate our attention, our focus, and how those things go awry in psychiatric diseases, diseases like post-traumatic stress disorder and depression. And then using that knowledge, can we construct novel treatments, brain-based treatments, that rewire these circuits and get people better? So we get to the point where we understand the individual's brain, what that individual needs, and then provide it to them, and research becomes this highway of taking ideas into new clinical interventions. Really change the face of a set of disorders, psychiatric disorders, which haven't seen really any dramatic advances in our ability to treat them for decades. So the kind of work that we do, I think in neuroscience in general, but especially the kind of work we do, really demands a lot of different kinds of expertise talking to each other who may not normally talk to each other in other contexts. So for example, we have psychiatrists, psychologists, experimental psychologists, basic neuroscientists, computer scientists, bioengineers, electrical engineers, all in the same place, all trying to achieve this mission. And inherently, the mission is interdisciplinary. It's understanding the brain as circuits, needing tools to explore it, needing new data analytic tools to analyze what comes out, needing an understanding of the clinical reality and fashioning treatments and understanding relationship to current treatments. All of that, that big vision, requires really a big diversity of expertise, and that's what makes the lab so exciting, and I think that's what really drives a lot of the people within the lab.
Because I started touching on that, okay, so I did all this sociology thing, and then I worked with two clinical psychologists after, and I started talking about the couple study, and then I'm a little sure I mentioned Hector's too.
I trained in the lab of Eric Kandel during my MD-PhD. Eric is a Nobel laureate, actually won the Nobel Prize in my second year in the lab, and seeing his experience, his thoughts, the way he works, understanding the clinical interactions I was having during school and afterwards in my clinical training, all of those things really coalesced into an idea of how to take rigorous science, apply it to a clinical question or set of questions, and ride that interface between basic discovery and clinical application to hopefully do some good. For me, success as a scientist personally would mean doing something through the science that impacts a much broader number of people. Not just to provide new knowledge and build upon science as sort of the big S science, but that the science leads to new things happening for people suffering from mental illnesses that would not have otherwise happened. In other words, that I can, through my work, impact many lives more so than I could as a clinician seeing one patient at a time. Look within yourself. If there is a desire to know more, to push the boundaries, to answer your own questions, and you're constantly coming up with questions, you're constantly intellectually curious, listen to that. And that's the thing that will guide you in science. Science is not about making an easy buck and just having a 9-to-5 career. It's a hard road. There's a lot of obstacles. There's a lot of challenges. I mean, if we knew all the answers, it wouldn't be research. It is a life passion. If If you don't feel that life passion, maybe it's not the right road for you. But if you do, there's plenty of ways to get good training, plenty of ways to get good mentorship. Sticking with it, being determined, and really wanting to see the answer because you want to see the answer, that I think is, at least for me, what's kept me going and keeps me going.